sent by Jesus to share the real story of Easter.
Yeah, it's not all about Easter bunnies and finding the kids.
Where should I start? The Last Supper.
Of course, duh.
Started at the Passover, when the disciples came to Jesus and asked, "Where do you want us to prepare the Passover meal for you? As you go into the city, you will see a man. Tell him, 'The teacher says, my time has come, and I will eat the Passover meal with my disciples at your house.'" So the disciples did as Jesus told them and prepared the Passover meal there. When it was evening, Jesus sat down at the table with the disciples.
"I tell you the truth, one of you will betray me." "One of you here will betray me, for the Son of Man must die, as scriptures say long ago, but how terrible it will be for the one who betrays him. It'd be better if he was never born."
Judas, the one who would betray him, also asked,
"Rabbi, am I the one?"
"Yes."
As they were eating, Jesus took some bread and blessed it. Then he broke it into pieces and gave it to the disciples, saying,
"Take this and eat it, for this is my body."
And he took a cup of wine and gave thanks to God for it. He gave it to them and said,
"Take this and drink it, for this is my blood. It confirms the covenant between God and his people and is poured out as a sacrifice to forgive the sins of many." Later, Jesus was betrayed by Judas and was taken to the presence, where he was named guilty for declaring to be the Christ. He was beaten and then sent to the cross to be crucified. When the soldiers were crucifying Jesus, they divided his cloths among them. They also took his robe and said,
"Rather than tearing it apart, let us throw dice for it."
Standing near the cross were Jesus' mother, Mary and Mary Magdalene. When Jesus saw his mother standing there beside him, John, he said to her,
"Dear woman, here's your son. Mary, here's your mother."
Jesus knew that his work was now finished and said,
"I'm thirsty."
A jar of sour wine was sitting there, so they soaked a sponge in it and put it on a branch, and they held it up to his lips. When Jesus had tasted it, he said,
"It is finished."
Then he bowed his head and gave up his spirit.
Sunday morning, Mary Magdalene came to the tomb and found that the stone had been rolled away from the entrance. She ran to find Peter and John. Peter and John went to the tomb and looked inside. It was empty. Now they understood the scriptures that said Jesus must rise from the dead.
"Dear woman, why are you crying?"
"I don't know where they put Jesus." She turned to leave and saw someone standing there. It was Jesus, but she didn't recognize him.
"Dear woman, why are you crying? Who are you looking for?"
"Taken Jesus' body."
"Mary."
"Master."
That Sunday evening, the disciples were meeting behind locked doors because they were afraid of the Jewish leaders. Suddenly, Jesus was standing there with them.
"Peace be with you."
He showed them the wounds in his hands and his sides. They were filled with joy when they saw the Lord.
Then Jesus breathed on them and said, "Receiving the Holy Spirit, if you forgive anyone's sins, they are forgiven. I have been given all authority in heaven and on earth."
Jesus also said, "Therefore, go and make disciples of all the nations, baptizing them in the name of the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit. Teach these new disciples to obey all the commands I have given you, and be sure of this, I am with you always.